So what did we learn from the first project which were launched in 2009? We realized that through this type of public partnership, you can establish a common database that you could never establish without such collaborative approach. You have also a nice opportunity to develop new tools for the identification of drug targets, also to standardize those tools, to standardize models and assays for drug efficacy and drug safety. This is very high on the agenda of IMI, this concept of standardization and harmonization. I mentioned patient-centric research, and indeed, patient-reported outcome are the basis of a number of our projects, as I will briefly illustrate in a moment. Classification of disease, IMI is quite ambitious to contribute to develop a new taxonomy of disease, which will give more importance to the molecular basis of the disease, paving the way to more personalized, tailored therapies. So just very briefly, a few examples. This is an example of a consortium working on a new classification of asthma based on a number of parameters derived from metabolomics, proteomics, transcriptomics, but also integrated in this handprint are patient-reported outcomes. As you can see, this consortium already produced a consensus statement for the classification of asthma. This is another example dealing with pulmonary disease. In this case, it's chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, where patients themselves are reporting the level of their physical activity through this device. They are also reporting their symptoms by answering a standardized questionnaire through this smartphone. Just to give you some idea of the type of project which are conducted. Education and training is also part of IMI activities with a project on pharmacoepidemiology, pharmacovigilance, project on drug safety, project aiming at harmonizing the education and training on pharmaceutical science across Europe are present as well. The M-Train project is indeed trying to harmonize all these, and for example, they recently have their first PhD workshop for students involved in public-private research projects. So I would like to insist on the role of SMEs. And I think this is especially relevant to the fifth goal, which will be discussed today. As you can see, we have a number of small and medium-sized enterprises engaged, and most of these companies are indeed within the biotech sector. Concrete example, the IMIDIA project, which is a project dedicated to diabetes, where one academic team discovered a method to generate the first human beta cell line that can be used for drug development. An SME took care of the commercialization of this cell line, and within the same consortium, large pharma companies involved in the development of innovative anti-diabetes drugs are also collaborating with the academics and the SME. And this was indeed recognized by opinion leaders in the US as a significant achievement in this publication in the Journal of Clinical Investigation. Another example where SMEs plays an important role, this is the ETOX consortium dedicated to in silico toxicology, taking advantage of a number of system biology and bioinformatic approaches, for example, allowing to predict the action of new drugs on the cardiac rhythm just by a simulation on a computer, as described in this publication. And as you can see from this other publication, which is authored by members of SMEs only, they really emphasize in this correspondence to Nature Biotechnology how they see their role within IMI in shaping the future of pharmaceutical research. If you would like to know more about IMI, this paper is just in press, and it will give you a broader overview and more details of the ongoing projects. So we are starting to measure together with others and the deputy chair of the scientific committee, Dan Cromlin, that you will hear soon, is working closely with us on measuring the real added value of this type of partnership. So we start to measure our first performance indicators. And as you can see, after only 2 years of true operation, there is already a number of scientific publications published in peer-reviewed journals. And when we look at the milestones in the work plans of the project, we see that most of them indeed were quite successful in reaching the majority of these milestones. So now, coming back to the COAL5, which is, I would say, officially announced today with all the information that is made available to you. The timeline for submission of the expression of interest is quite tight, the 16th of May. We will come very soon with the decision on the ranking so that the first rank expression of interest consortium, we can start rapidly to work with the large pharma companies to develop the full project proposal, for which we aim at having a decision early October, and to proceed with the real start of the project and the first payments before the end of the year. So it's quite an ambitious timeline, but it's really important indeed to move forward rapidly. So obviously, again, if you are here, is that because you are thinking to find partners to prepare your expression of interest. And for this, there are a number of tools available on the website. You can also contact your IMI State Representative Group member, and you will find their coordinated here, as well as the national contact points. Several of them are with us today. We also know that in Germany there has been a tool developed also dedicated to partnering that you could consult with benefit. If you want to follow not only COAL5 but IMI in general, you will find in your documentation and on your USB key a number of ways to do so. So I would like also to specify that although we launched COAL5 today, we are already working on the next COAL. The next COAL should be around antimicrobial resistance. There are still ongoing discussions at the level of the pharma companies to specify the details of what the companies are expecting from the COAL and also the budget they are ready to commit it. As soon as we will have this information, we will launch the consultation, which is foreseen, with the state representative as well as with the scientific committee. There has always been a workshop on this topic, but we are waiting for additional information to launch the final consultation. So we hope that after this consultation, this call will be indeed launched. And it should be the case certainly before the summer, at least that's our goal, even in May probably. But for this we are dependent on the FPI proposal. So other topics for COAL7, which are currently considered, deal with health technology assessment and new methods related to pharmacovigilance, as well as a topic on the assessment of the impact of vaccination.